All right, question for you. What do these four computers have in common? Let's find out. Hello, everyone, and welcome back. My name is Ian. This is Learn How to Edit Stuff, and I've got a new intro, and I'm feeling pretty good about it. So, those four computers in the intro, what do they all have in common? The answer, they could all utilize multi-frame rendering to give your workflow process and speed a nice, significant boost regardless of the machine that you're on. So I went and tested this After Effects benchmark project on all four of those computers with multi-frame rendering turned on and off. Now, as you can imagine, doing something of this scale, I had to set a few ground rules, okay? So on all four computers, every single operating system was up to date. The graphics card drivers were up to date. I was rendering to the fastest internal drive in each computer. OBS was capturing the screen with the lowest possible CPU draw. They were all running After Effects version 22. All memory and cache was purged before each test, plus each machine got a restart before every test as well, and there were no other programs running in the background. Now, to me, this seemed like a pretty decent foundation to run these benchmark tests across four different computers, and you can't even imagine how long it took me to update all the operating systems and everything, but we did it, we're here, we're making this video, and the results may shock you. Maybe not. Coming in dead last was my trusty rusty 2014 MacBook Pro. With multi-frame rendering turned on, it clocked in at a staggering 34 minutes and 28 seconds. With multi-frame rendering turned off, even worse, 46 minutes and 21 seconds. Okay, yes, both of those numbers are terrible. I couldn't imagine waiting 34 minutes for a render, but what I want you guys to realize is that multi-frame rendering is kind of breathing new life into this old computer and actually giving it a nice boost, saving almost 10 minutes worth of render time using multi-frame rendering as opposed to using it without. So Adobe is kind of like giving your old hardware a little bit more longevity in a way if you're still using an old computer, which is pretty fantastic. So Mac coming in last place, great. Third place, the custom MSI computer build, which has actually fairly decent specs. With multi-frame rendering turned on, it clocked in at 16 minutes and 45 seconds. And with multi-frame rendering turned off, 22 minutes and 37 seconds. Now this one's not a shocking spread like the MacBook Pro was, but it still did pretty decent, saving about 6 minutes of render time, which is still pretty good. Third place, MSI, you did okay. Bronze medal. Okay, coming in at second place is the Alienware Aurora R12, which has been my daily driver for a little over a year now. With multi-frame rendering turned on, it clocked in at 6 minutes and 15 seconds, and with MFR turned off, 12 minutes and 52 seconds, which is more than a 50% decrease in speed. So my Alienware computer does have pretty good specs, all things considered, especially when you put it up against the MSI computer and the MacBook Pro. I thought it was pretty fast and pretty good. Until I ran the benchmark test on my unbelievable custom Puget Systems build, which absolutely blew it out of the water. No contest whatsoever. Coming in first place, Puget Systems. Beating out the Alienware by more than double, clocking in at only 2 minutes and 55 seconds with multi-frame rendering turned on, and 11 minutes and 3 seconds with multi-frame rendering off, which is a staggeringly noticeable difference. Now, at the conclusion of all these tests, there are a couple things that we need to talk about, okay? Number one, if you're not using multi-frame rendering in After Effects, what are you even doing? Go to Edit, Preferences, Memory and Performance, and make sure multi-frame rendering is enabled. You can even set the CPU reserve if you'd like, but I left all of the tests at 10% since that seems pretty reasonable, but multi-frame rendering can use 100% of your CPU if you want it to. And on top of boosting your render times, multi-frame rendering will also pre-render your timeline if left idle, which is super nice, and it also is utilized when using Adobe Media Encoder. So lots of benefits to using multi-frame rendering. If you're not using it already, what are you doing here? Why are you watching my channel? Are you subscribed yet? Subscribe to my channel, drop a comment in the comment section below, leave a thumbs up on this video if you liked multi-frame rendering AE benchmark test across four different computers. Are you that nerdy? I am. So why test all these computers? What's the point of even doing this exercise? The point is, and you know I love talking about this, it's one of my favorite subjects, is saving time, and time is money. I say it all the time. The more time you can save, the more money you make. Even if it's not financial money, it's time money. The equation makes sense, all right? Time is money, and just just understand that, especially as an editor. If you're trying to get into a career as an editor in post-production, time and efficiency are your best friends, and those are the two things that you can't really get back, so you have to be good about both. That's why we tested all four of these computers. Could you imagine rendering one thing 34 minutes on a Mac when it takes me 2 minutes and 30 seconds on this computer here? Like, I could render 11 timelines in the amount of time that you can render one, okay? So, if you're already an editor, if you're trying to get into editing, if you're looking for freelance work, if you're trying to make money at this, time is money. So, working on a 2014 MacBook Pro is not making you as much money as working on something like a Puget Systems rig or a better computer than what you're currently working on, okay? Here's the thing. You get a faster computer, you can work faster, you can work more efficiently, you can export faster, you can render faster, you can take on more clients, you can do more work, you can make changes faster, you can do all these things because time is not a factor for you anymore. Think of all the work that you can't do because you're kind of stuck working on a slow computer or what. Do you guys hear that? Now, if you are considering upgrading your computer rig, might I politely point you in the direction of Puget Systems that build unbelievable computers that work super, super well for creatives, especially when they're working with the Adobe Creative Suite. Plus, their customer service is top, top, top quality. I mean, they were sending me pictures of my computer as it was being built and even putting cute little post-it notes inside of it. And with my computer, they sent me this binder with like tons of benchmark tests and like data and like all this crazy stuff, and they didn't send it to me until it was ready to be sent to me. They care. They care about their products. And if you care, I would suggest checking the link in the video description below that will give you information about the rig that I have and more information about Puget Systems as a company. I could not suggest them any more highly or any more than I can in this video because my experience with them has been fantastic and I care about time is money. That's my favorite equation. Screw everything else I learned in school. Time is money. Why don't they teach you that? Good thing I'm here. Learn how to edit stuff. Smash that subscribe button, that thumbs up button, and leave a comment in the comment section below. And that's it. That's the video, okay? What I want you to walk away from after watching this video is understanding that Adobe has now given your computer new life in the form of multi-frame rendering. Adobe's like, here you go. Your computer just works better now in After Effects. That's fantastic, okay? So no matter what kind of rig that you have, make sure that you're enabling multi-frame rendering and using it inside of Adobe After Effects because it's amazing and it's great and it speeds everything up. It makes you happier. It makes me happier. We're all happier. The second part of this equation is if you're trying to be an editor, if you're trying to get into this and take that next step in your career and you're a freelancer or whatever, I would consider upgrading your rig so that you can remove the sluggishness of your computer holding you down from the equation. Because as soon as you can get rid of that, it opens up so many more creative possibilities and workflow processes and like all this stuff just kind of magically happens because you don't have to wait around anymore. You're not sitting there waiting for your computer to compute. You can just work and work fluidly. And it's just, oh God, it's such a nice way of life. Links in the video description below for Puget Systems. All of my information on my computer rig is down there as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really, truly appreciate it. If you have not already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Drop a comment in the comment section below. Smash that thumbs up button. There are Linktree links in the description as well. You can follow me on social media and find all of my favorite editing goodies like AE Juice and Epidemic Sound and a bunch of other fun stuff down there. Puget Systems, thank you. This whole video, this was an experiment. This was a crazy one. I spent a lot of time upgrading computers that have been collecting dust on my shelf simply to do this video, so I hope that you appreciate it. Thank you so much. My name is Ian. This is Learn How to Edit Stuff, and I will see you in the next one.